Hello students, welcome to today's class. So we all have electric circuit at home. Electric circuit is the path along which electric current flows. In an electric circuit, there can be many electrical components. An electric fuse is an essential part of an electric circuit. Electric fuse. So, electric fuse is a device which limits the flow of current in an electric circuit. So electric fuse is a device which limits the flow of current in an electric circuit. Then, what is the principle of electric circuit? The principle of electric circuit is the heating effect of electric current. Heating effect of electric current. So, electric fuse is made up of an alloy of lead and tin. A fuse wire is made up of an alloy of lead and tin. This is the material which is used to make electric fuse wire. Then what are the characteristics of a fuse wire? So a fuse wire has low melting point and high resistance. A fuse wire has low melting point and high resistance. These are the characteristics of fuse. Now, we will see some pictures showing how an electric fuse is connected in an electric circuit. And also we will see the working of an electric fuse and how an electric fuse save the appliance. So an electric fuse is always connected on the live wire. So let us see more details. So this is the fuse arrangement. How an electric fuse is fitted in a circuit. The two main parts of an electric fuse are socket and porcelain holder. The part socket is fixed on the board. This part of the electric fuse is fitted on the board. So you can see it cannot be removed. It is fixed on the board. So it has two terminals named as T1 and T2. There are two terminals named as T1 and T2. Only live wire is connected to the terminals. So live wire is not directly passing. So one end of the live wire is connected to terminal 2 and one end is connected to terminal 1. Between this terminal 1 and terminal 2, there is a gap. There is a gap between T1 and T2. So, only live wire passes through the electric fuse. No neutral connection and earth connection are there with the electric fuse. So this is the socket part. Now the next part is porcelain holder. So holder part. This is the holder part. It can be inserted into the socket and it can be taken out from the socket. So it is porcelain is an insulator. Porcelain is an insulator. So that when we hold this holder, we don't get electric shock. So here also you can see two terminals T1 and T2. These are the two terminals. Then on joining this terminal 1 and terminal 2, on joining terminal 1 and terminal 2, a fuse wire is tied joining T1 and T2. After that, we insert this holder into the socket. We insert this holder into the socket. When this part is inserted into the socket, then terminal 1 and terminal 2 are joined by this wire. Terminal 1 and terminal 2 are joined with this wire, and the circuit will become complete. The circuit will become complete and the appliances will work. Okay, and suppose that there are some problems in the electric circuit. So we have already inserted this holder into the socket and the circuit is complete. Suppose that there are some problems in the electric circuit, like overflow of current or voltage fluctuations or short circuiting in the circuit, then there will be high resistance, and whenever there are defects in the electric circuit, then what will happen? Due to that high resistance in the electric circuit, this fuse wire will melt. So when fuse wire will melt, this is a fuse wire which is tied between terminal 1 and terminal 2. Whenever there are any defects in the circuit, like short circuit, voltage fluctuation, etc., then this fuse wire will melt. And a gap is created. When the fuse wire will melt, so this gap will be produced between this terminal 1 and terminal 2. So when this fuse wire will melt, a gap will be created between terminal 1 and terminal 2, and the electricity won't reach to the appliance, and the appliance won't work. So this way the appliances are saved. Otherwise, if heavy current reaches to the appliance can be damaged. Since this fuse wire melt and a gap is created in the circuit, electricity won't reach to the appliance and the appliances are saved. This way an electric fuse save the appliance. So this is another type of electric fuse. Its name is cartridge type fuse. Cartridge type fuse. So you can see a glass case, and inside this glass case there is a fuse wire, and on either side metal caps are there. So costly appliances like refrigerator, air conditioner, geyser, television, these are all provided with cartridge type fuse, and these fuses are available in variable current ratings like 1 ampere, 2 ampere, 5 ampere, 10 ampere, etc. Now we see the reason for connecting the fuse in the live wire. What is the reason for connecting the fuse in the live wire? So this is an electrical appliance. Electrical appliance. Every electrical appliance must be connected with a live wire and a neutral wire. Every electrical appliance must be connected with a live wire and a neutral wire. Every electrical appliance has two terminals, one for connecting the live wire and one for connecting the neutral wire. See this diagram, this is the main. In this one, this is the live wire and this is the neutral wire. And in this diagram you can see the fuse is connected with the live wire, and fuse is connected with the live wire. You can see, suppose that there are problems in the circuit, current is going through the live wire and reach to the appliance. Suppose that due to some problems in the electric circuit, overflow of current, the electric fuse melts, the fuse wire melts, and a gap is created in the circuit. Current is going through the live wire, so it reaches up to here. Current reaches up to here. It is not reaching to the appliance. And if you touch the appliance, here current is not reaching to the appliance. And if you touch on the appliance, you won't get an electric shock, because current is going through the live wire, and since fuse is gone, the current does not reach to the appliance. And if you repair this appliance, you can do it, because if you touch the appliance, you won't get electric shock because current is not reaching to the appliance. Now we will see, suppose that the fuse is connected with the neutral wire, then what would happen? So in this diagram you can see fuse is connected to the neutral wire. Here see, fuse is connected to the neutral wire. So current is going through the live wire. Here also, first current is reaching to the appliance. After that only it goes to the fuse. Suppose that the fuse melts. Fuse melts due to some problems in the flow of current. Now you see, in this case what will happen? The fuse is gone. And the circuit becomes incomplete. Fuse is gone. So there is a gap in the circuit. So the appliance will not work, because there is a The circuit is incomplete. There is a gap in the circuit. So, appliance won't work. But what will happen if you touch on the appliance? Now you see, live wire current is reaching to the appliance. Even though the appliance is not working, current is reaching to the appliance. And in this case, if you touch the appliance, you can get electric shock because current is reaching to the appliance. Appliance is not working since fuse is gone. There is a incomplete circuit. Appliance won't work, but current is there on the appliance. And if you touch on the appliance, in this case, you can get a severe electric shock. This is what is happening if you connect a fuse in the neutral wire. So we have seen the importance of fuse in an electric circuit. Whenever there is a overloading of current in the electric circuit, the fuse saves the electric circuit from getting damaged. And electric fuse must be always connected with the live wire. Otherwise it is useless. And when we select a fuse wire, that should be of proper current carrying capacity. So in the case of appliances like a bulb, fan, etc., fuse of less current rating is enough. But for appliances which are consuming heavy current, like air conditioner and all, a fuse of high current rating is required. And when we put a fuse wire of proper current carrying capacity must be used. Suppose that the current carrying capacity of your appliance is 5 ampere. Current carrying capacity of your appliance is 5 ampere and you use a fuse of 15 ampere. In that case, what will happen? 15 ampere current can go to the appliance. But if 15 ampere current will reach to that appliance can be damaged. So if the current carrying capacity of that appliance is 5 ampere, then you should use a fuse wire of 5 ampere. If a heavy current reaches to that appliance, the appliance cannot withstand up to that much current. So, a wire of proper current carrying capacity must be used. Nowadays, instead of electric fuse, we are using MCB. The full form of MCB is miniature circuit breaker. Full form of MCB is miniature circuit breaker. So, what is the disadvantage of electric fuse? The disadvantage of electric fuse is that once there is overloading in the electric circuit, the fuse wire will melt and save the appliances. In that case, we have to remove the holder part, porcelain holder. We have to take it out and we have to tie a new fuse wire connecting the terminals. And again, we have to insert the holder into the socket. Then the appliances will work. So manually we have to do it. In the case of miniature circuit breaker, whenever there is overloading or any problem in the electric circuit, it will automatically cut off the supply. Miniature circuit breaker will automatically cut off the supply. Okay, and when the MCB is automatically cut off, after that we have to find out the defect in the electric circuit, and after removing the problem, again we can raise the lever upward, then again it will work. The advantage is that it will automatically cut off the supply. No need of a replacement of any wire. That is the advantage. So today we have seen what is electric fuse, principle of electric fuse, of which material it is made up of. It is made up of an alloy of lead and tin. Then what are the characteristics of electric fuse, to which wire a fuse is connected, and why it is connected to a live wire, and what would happen if it is connected to a neutral wire, and what are precautions we had to take, and what is the advantage of MCB over an electric fuse. These all points we have seen. In next class, we will discuss a new topic.